Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of God, the source of mercy for all the creation and the source of compassion for the believing congregation. As-salatu was-salamu ala anbiya illahi jami'an wa ala sayyidihim wa khatanihim habibi ilahi al-alameen Abul Qasim al-Mustafa Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Sallallahu alayhi wa ala ahli baytih al-tayyibin al-tahirin al-ma'sumin. May his peace and blessings be upon all of his messengers, his prophets, who sacrificed their life to guide us and enlighten us. Tonight, we will read from chapter 10, Surat Yunus, Jonah, verse 10. I will read 9 and 10, inshallah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ يَهْدِيهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِإِيمَانِهِمْ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ دَعْوَاهُمْ فِيهَا سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ وَتَحِيَّتُهُمْ فِيهَا سَلَامٌ وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين صدق الله العلي العظيم
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
سورة يونس آية نمبر 10. دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام. Allah says when people go to paradise, many people ask, what people do in paradise? Because they are stuck there, you know, no exit. Aren't they going to be bored? So what sort of activities they have? Here, we have many activities. Here, people worship God, people have to work. If people do not go to work, they're going to get bored. The surveys say that the main cause of domestic violence at home, quarreling between husband and wife, because they have nothing important to keep themselves busy with. Therefore, they fight. People, when they are unemployed, they are not busy with something productive, something important, then they start fighting over small things. So in paradise, when people go to paradise, we ask, what is the main, you know, engagement there? God answers it in 3 points. He says, دَعْوَاهُمْ فِيهَا سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ. They keep themselves busy. Da'wah is not how the Farsi connotation, da'wah min Quran, no, no, alhamdulillah. No more da'wah in paradise. No more fightings. No more fightings because people fight. The reason why people fight because of their intellectual or psychological deficiency. They fight. They act like children. But when they get mature, they don't fight. So in paradise, all people are supposed to be mature. They don't fight. They don't have psychological issues. They don't have emotional. They don't have intellectual issues. They don't have deficiency in any department. Everything is there. Sometimes scarcity over resources. When resources are scarce, people fight. So their engagement, their main engagement, their is the connection and chatting with their Lord. Da'wah here means dua, their supplication, their conversation. They glorify God. da'wahum fiha in paradise, subhanaka Allahumma. Glorification of God. Subhanallah is to sanctify Him. The meaning of subhanallah, the exact meaning. Why do we say subhanallah? Is to sanctify God, is to say, God, you are above everything in this universe. You have no resemblance. In this universe, you are unique. You are unmatched and paralleled. You are unique. This is the meaning of sanctifying God. Because when we attribute to Him, when we attribute to Him human characters, we are bringing Him down. So we have to sanctify Him. He's above. He created humans, but He's above them. He's above humans. This is the meaning of tasbih. Tasbih is sanctification or glorification. Very few, we have been told that the people of paradise, their fuel there that gives them energy and reason to live is glorification. Glorification. Tasbih. And they enjoy it. In paradise, there are some sensual gratifications, there are some physical gratifications, but above these is the spiritual gratification when they speak directly to God. That is the biggest enjoyment. The biggest enjoyment of the people of paradise is when God gives them attention and they have direct access to Him and they speak to Him directly. That is the prime thrilling and enjoyment of paradise. Same thing in this life. In this life we have people who always feel lonely. They always feel they are lonely. Others, they might not feel lonely. Why people feel lonely? Because they have a gap in their life, in their heart. Maybe because they don't have friends, they don't have family members around them. Or maybe they do have friends and family members and acquaintances, but they don't have good relationship with them. When people don't have good relationship among themselves, they feel lonely. They feel estranged. There are some husbands who live in a house with their wives and kids, but still they are not happy. There are some wives who live in a family with her husband, with her kids, but she's unhappy. Because the relationship are broken. They don't have good relationship. They feel lonely. So, for people to enjoy this life, they have to have good relationship. And we need the vertical one and the horizontal one. The vertical with God and horizontal with people. We have to fix these two relationships in order for us to enjoy this short-lived life, few days we have in this life. It's not worth it that we always quarrel and fight and be jealous and hate and attack. It's not worth it really. Imam Zainul Abidin has something very important. Our fourth Imam, Al-Imam Ali ibn Hussein, he is the son of Imam Hussein. He was nurtured and raised by Imam Hussein. His father is Imam Hussein. His mother is Shah Zanam, the daughter of the Persian emperor. So he comes from two great families, an Arab family and a Persian family. Imam Zainul Abidin, Ali ibn Hussein, and Imam al-Sajjad. He says, if God creates me, and He puts me on earth, and the earth is empty of everything. There is no friends, no family members, nobody on earth. And I only have this book with me, the Quran, I would not feel lonely. I would not feel lonely. If God puts me on earth, and the earth is empty of people, nobody is on earth. But I have this book with me, the Holy Quran. I don't feel lonely because I have everything. I have a good relationship. I have God. God is talking to me. Sometimes we get bored because there are no people around us. We need people around us to speak to them. Imam Zain al-Abidin says, as long as I speak to God, He's with me. I don't need people anymore. I don't feel the wahsha, solitude, or loneliness. I don't feel it. And he's a true. A man who was able to produce Dua Abi Hamza al-Thamali that some of you read during the nights of Ramadan, that high caliber of communion and conversation with God, that man is a true. When he says, if I have only the Quran, I'll be the happiest person. When Allah fills the heart, but the problem, how do you fill your heart with God? God is there, He's not absent. And we are here. But how do you establish this connection? This is the challenge. The challenge is to be able to connect with the Wi-Fi. Sometimes we have a problem, we can't connect. The Wi-Fi is there and we have this device, but there is no connection. The challenge is how to connect safely. How to connect with God. Once this connection is established, your heart is empowered with faith, with tranquility, with peace, with being peace. And this is exactly the wording of the Holy Quran. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. The true believers are those who find tranquility and peace with the remembrance of God, with the friendship of God. Allah, indeed, Allah bidhikrillahi tatma'innu al-qulub. Indeed, the only way to find tranquility and peace is with God's remembrance. God's remembrance is the food. Food for the spirit, food for the heart. So in paradise, Allah says, they are busy, da'wahum fiha, Subhanaka Allahumma. They keep themselves busy speaking to God, glorifying Him, and He will speak to them too. It's a two-way communication. Two-way communication. Da'wahum fiha Subhanaka Allahumma. Then, only they speak to God? Only that? No, God said there's something else. Da'wahum fiha Subhanaka Allahumma wa tahiyyatuhum fiha salam. They have this vertical relationship with their Lord. At the same time, they maintain the horizontal relationship with people around them. You need people around you. Sometimes you say, I have God in my heart. I don't need anyone. This is not true. This is not true. God says, you need me. But sometimes through people you reach to me. How is that? Sometimes through a kind of an act of kindness to an orphan you reach to. How do we reach to God? Is there any ladder we put and we, like Pharaoh? Pharaoh said, put the longest, tallest ladder in Egypt so I can find God. Where is Ilahu Musa? Musa says, I have a Lord sitting there. I want to discover Him. Is this the way we discover God? This is not the way. So how do we reach to Him? What elevator can take us to God? Through acts of kindness, act of wholesomeness, you find God. When you do something good to someone, to an orphan, to a sick person, to a lost person, to a confused person, to a lonely person, any human, don't look at their gender, don't look at their color, don't look at their language, any person. That act of kindness is going to elevate you and send you to God. It's going to connect you to God. So in paradise, they need both. They need God to converse with Him, and they need to be good with those who are around them. وَتَحِيَّتُهُمْ فِيهَا السَّلَامُ. Tahiyya, although the simple meaning of tahiyya is a greetings, but in this context, it means relationship. Their relationship with others is peace, salam. maturity. This is what I said in the beginning. They are not quarreling. They have no disputes. They have no jealousy. Their hearts are cleansed and refined. The reason why we fast for 30 days, the reason why we pray 5 times a day is to cleanse the heart. Sometimes it works with some people and sometimes it never works. Never works. I said here many times, if you remember, during the month of Ramadan, some people are fasting in Ramadan, fasting and praying, and they do Taraweeh. But also they are killing other people through bombing them in Yemen with airplanes, with missiles. They are killing women and children and places of worship. And you know how many mosques, not a church, not a synagogue, not a nightclub, a mosque was destroyed in Yemen during the month of Ramadan by the bombing of a Muslim government. A government that considers itself to be the custodian of the holy shrines, Mecca and Medina. Mosques were destroyed in Yemen. Not nightclubs, huh? Although we also disagree with destroying a nightclub or church or synagogue or any place. Any place. But see, hypocrisy. This is hypocrisy. This means that their fasting and their prayers are fruitless. Fruitless. Not only does not have positive effect, it has negative effect. Why? The heart is sick. And when the heart is sick, it cannot produce something good. Allah says in this book, in the Holy Quran, وَالْبَلَدُ الطَّيِّبُ يَخْرُجُ نَبَاتُهُ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ. The ambience, the environment that is good, is going to produce something good. But the environment that is contaminated, it produces nothing but evil. Do you follow me, Mahdi? وَالْبَلَدُ الطَّيِّبُ يَخْرُجُ نَبَاتُهُ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ. The good ambience. It will produce something good. When your heart is good, when your house is good, when your family is good, then your results are going to be all good. But if the heart is sick with hypocrisy, with jealousy, with enmity, with hate, with anger, وَالَّذِي خَبُثَ, as to the one that is evil, لَا يَخْرُجُ إِلَّا نَكِدًا, produces nothing but terrible results and bad results. This is in this book. So sometimes fasting and prayers, they cleanse, they make us true human beings, they fill the heart with love, forgiveness, compassion, and sometimes it does not work. I've seen some medicines, it works with some patients and they don't work with other patients. Either there's something wrong with the doctor, or the medicine, or the patient. You have to find it yourself. So then, people of paradise, they converse with God, and also they have irtibat and connection with the community of the believers around them. وَتَحِيَّتُهُمْ فِيهَا السَّلَامُ. And mind you that the beauty of your relationship with God, the quality of your relationship with God is reflected on your relationship with people. Meaning that if our relationship with people is safe and good and healthy, this is a reflection that your relationship with God is good and healthy and safe. But if relationship with people around us is based on tension, on rivalry, on race, towards materialism, towards this lower life, then this means that your relationship with God is broken. There is a correlation between them. The beauty of your interaction with people, it means that your relationship with God is also beautiful, safe and beautiful. So keep it, strengthen that relationship. If one day you find yourself, you don't like people around you, we are sick and tired of people. If one day we find that there is jealousy in my heart towards this person or that person, if one day I'm unwilling to forgive, I'm unwilling to understand, I'm unwilling to cooperate with others, then this means that my worshipping has a defect. I have to revise it. My relationship with God has a defect. I have to go and find out and diagnose what's wrong with that. Sometimes some of these diseases that hits the worshipping. You know, what is the common disease with people? Common diseases, heart problem, you know, blood pressure, this, that. What is the common disease in the ibadah? In worshipping. What is the common disease? Nifaq. Ahsant, nifaq, hypocrisy, and ostentation, riya. That we worship but not for him, for people. To earn the praise of the people, not the praise of God. Wow, God says you are losing your credit. You are not gaining anything. You are not gaining anything. قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعِيهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنَعًا. They lose. They are not doing it for God. They are doing it for a purpose in their heart. To show off. To tell the people, I'm serving, listen, I'm helping, I'm serving. Now it's good to tell people, to encourage them. But if the only aim and objective is people but not God, we lose the credit. This is what the Quran teaches us. This is in this book. Quran says, I want you to grow. And growing is only, it takes place when we dedicate, when we have an element called what? Huh? An element called Ikhlas. Ikhlas, we have to be specific. Ikhlas means earnestness. I am doing it for God. Even if people abuse me, even if people speak ill of me, even if some people you give them good things, they return bad things to you. Still you keep doing the good things. This is ikhlas. This is ikhlas. This is the highest level of faith and commitment. And then the third, Allah says, so number one, conversing with Allah. دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم. Sanctification, glorification. وتحييتهم, their relationship with people is salam, peace. And third one, وآخر دعواهم. And their last, آخر means last. Their last desire, or their last relationship, وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. They pay attention that what we earned in paradise, it is because of God, not because of me. If I make it to paradise, it's not because of me. It's because of God had a special attention on me. It's by invitation. He found me worthy of pulling me, inviting me, of selecting me from among people. He found me worthy. And we have something similar in this life. Many people have money, but only few of them, they dedicate their money for others. Many people have money, but only 1% of them, they donate, they give with love. With love. Many people give, but without love. Many people give because they have to give. Others, they give, even if you don't tell them. They give with love. This is by special invitation. This is God is selecting and choosing. He says, I love those people. So he makes them his agents. In life we have agents. Some agents work for the FBI, Some agents work for governments, for some agents work for the media, some agents work for their families, and some, they decide to work for God. And when you work for God, you work for the humanity. You work for others. God's agents are only selected. Only selected. Because God looks at the hearts. When we go for a job interview, they don't look at our hearts. I could be the worst person on earth, yet I can earn that job. Because of my skills, because of my talents, because of my CV, because of my whatever. But God does not look at the CV. God looks at the heart. And thus He chooses His agents and His servants based on their hearts and their intentions, on their need. The need that we don't see. With physical eyes, we don't see. But God can see the need. Therefore, when they get what they get in paradise, the blessings of paradise, again, they say, this is due to God, not me. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَاهُمْ أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And whatever blessings He gives them, they get closer to Him. Because in this life, sometimes God bestows blessings on us, but we run away from Him. I know people when they did not have money, they were more religious, more committed to faith. As soon as they got money, they divorced, not their wives, the mosques. Some people divorced their wives, some people divorced the masjid. Some people divorce religion. I know some people were, they did not have good health, but they were very religious. As soon as he recovered, they left the masjid. They think that they need God only when they don't have money, when they don't have health. We need God at all times. So some ni'am, some blessings of God on us in this life, it makes us arrogant. Rather than becoming more humble, more committed to our communities, to God, it makes people rebel against God. And we have it in our children too. Some children you give them, they respect, they appreciate. Some children, the more you give them, the more they disrespect their parents. We do the same with God. Some of us, we do the same. God, He would give us, but we reject Him. إِنَّكَ تَدْعُونِي فَأُوَلِّي عَنْكَ وَتَتَحَبَّبُ إِلَيَّ فَأَتَبَغَّضُ إِلَيْكَ. You show me love, I show you hate. You invite me to come to you, I run away from you. This is what we read in the month of Ramadan. This is exactly how we treat God. But in paradise, when God gives them, they get to Him, they get closer to Him. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَاهُمْ أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ عالمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات إنك مجيب الدعوات إنك غافر الخطيئات إنك ماحي السيئات وجاعلها حسنات إنك على كل شيء قدير.